I'm Big Louie, and this is LOU2RETRO.
Yep.
Sadie and Mom were gone for the weekend, right? So it was just you and me. We had a good time.
Mm-hmm.
Did a lot of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Played Risk.
Mm-hmm.
Went game hunting.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So let's get right into it, right? So last week, our friend Hooper.
Hooper!
Had gotten some stuff, and he ended up wanting to do a couple trades with us. Well, actually, first one here is Mario Brothers Duck Hunt, which we didn't have this one, and so I told him to give him $2 for that, which is about what he paid for it. And then he traded us. He said they had this PlayStation Glover game, which, you know, is traditionally a bad game. It's kind of like N64, only with a glove. Yeah.
Well, Super Mario 64.
Oh, I'm sorry, Super Mario 64. Yeah, Super Mario 64, but you're playing as a glove. So, did that, traded him something that they would want to play a little bit more. So we gave him the Spec Ops game, which we don't want to play that.
Mm-hmm.
But that's more up their lane. I played it. It was okay. I just couldn't figure out how to... get past the first little level. So that happened last week, right?
Mm-hmm.
So then on Friday, after I picked Louie up from school, we went out to a couple different places. Went to a bunch of antique stores, which we never really been before.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't really find a whole lot of stuff.
But there was this one with a fish tank, and there's one fish. It looked like it teleported.
Yeah, it was just sitting there in the middle of the water, not moving at all.
No, not that one.
There was another one?
Yeah, it was like that kind of.
Yeah. So, and they had a giant, like, bird cage taller than me, and there was, like, a huge stuffed gorilla inside.
Mm-hmm.
That was pretty cool. So, we did stop by a Goodwill, and I searched, like, 3 different times all over this Goodwill, didn't really see anything, and I was coming to get Louie to say, hey, let's go, dude. And I just happened to look over, and I found this, which is a Bishu Incorporated Ultimate Super Stick is what it's called. And I'll try and get up here closer so you can see it. Whoop. There we go. So this thing is really cool. And at first, I didn't realize what it was for. It's got suction cups on the bottom. But it's got the same pinout as like a Sega or an Atari. I guess that's your, what do they call that, a D? It's called a D something, I can't remember. Anyway, it's a 9-pin D connector, I think it's called. So I did some research, and most of the ones that I saw on these were Nintendo ones, but this one I think is for a Sega Master System, or it says Atari also, which has 2 buttons. You can play left or right hand side, but I'm guessing it's for Sega Master System mostly, huh? Probably works with Atari too, I just don't know. I did test it with the Sega Master System and it worked, so that was cool. And got that for, I think it was like $3. And then we went to another place, which Hooper has told us about before. And it was really, really dirty, but we searched, you know, they were getting ready to close, and the guy kept overcharging me, and nothing was complete, but he did have this DS Lite, which we bought for $5, and didn't come with anything. Plugged it up when we got in the car, or actually went and got a, we also had a starter kit, DS starter kit, and it had a charger in it and a case and stuff. And it did have the red light on it, but it wouldn't power up. So, you know, after doing some research, there's some small fuses, and I might show a picture of the fuses, but there's a couple small fuses, but there was actually something rattling around in there, we noticed, which turned out to be the L2 inductor. Now, I tried soldering it back in there, and I'm not the best solder. This is so tiny when you're working with these things, but I think I may have
broke it.
No, I think either I did solder it in there correctly and the other fuses are bad, or I just didn't get a good solder point in there. So what I need to get is, we have a multimeter, but it's not a powered one. So I need to get a powered multimeter, or I can plug this up into the car and see where exactly the power is stopping on it. So we got to fix that. It's just going to take a little bit of time. So I think we can fix it. So then Sadie will have a DS, right? So that would be cool. So then... what else did we do? Okay. So then we went to a swap meet in the morning, right?
Mm-hmm.
A Saturday morning. And they had, the first right when we were walking in, there was a stand there, and they had a RAD 2.0 robot. That was pretty cool, huh? Yeah. And he got one at $45 for it, which we weren't going to pay him $45 for it. And he was saying they were going for $150 online, which I looked online, and I saw some cheaper ones, like way cheaper, like $30 or $40 ones. But we're not really in the robot business. But what I had thought was, you know, I see all these different mods people make for their Nintendos. You know, the NES toaster, which you still want one of those, right?
Nintoaster.
So I thought it would be really cool to put a Nintendo into a RAD 2.0 robot. And supposedly there's a lot of room inside that you can still mount stuff. And a lot of people have other projects they do with them. But I just thought that would be really cool to have that in there. And it's called the RAD 2.0. It couldn't have a cooler name, could it?
Mm-hmm.
No. So then we went to... we did stop by a CD warehouse because we really didn't find anything when we were going out yesterday. Nobody had any of their games. That guy said he was going to have the games today, didn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, nobody had any games out. So we went to CD warehouse and we're just going to pick up a bunch of $1.99 games, which we pretty much did. And I forgot we had a free game coming to us. So we got a $4 game for free. So the games we picked out were Gyromite, which I checked, this does not have the Famicom adapter in it. Wrecking Crew.
If you know how that game works, please tell us.
Yeah, we were playing it and did everything we thought we needed to on the first level, but could not get past that first level. Even got the little guy that's chasing you around trapped behind the door, but couldn't figure out what to do after that. So I guess we could watch a walkthrough or something or play through online, but I don't know. So, you know, these are really to continue our Black Box collection, which we're... Black Label collections. So we're going to have to start getting into this a little bit more of the pricier games here soon. We did have Excitebike, but we traded that to Hooper.
Mm-hmm.
So, see here, Cybernoid. This was our $4 game?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, this is our $4 game that they had, and it's got writing on it. Thanks, Noah Barnett, for writing on this thing. And this one was filthy. The inside of it was just, it was horrible.
Noah's watching this?
Hey, you need to stop writing on your games, Noah Barnett. The cool thing about this, when we started playing with it, is... I noticed that it's the same game as one of our plug-and-plays. We have an Commodore 64 plug-and-play, and this same game, and I'll have to compare the two sometime, but this is the same game that's in there. And I thought that was a really cool game. It's hard, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And then we got Rad Racer, which this is pretty cool, because this is another 3D game, just like World Runner. So that was really cool, huh? Good game. Dick Tracy, I was playing this one for a little bit. It's kind of like Ghostbusters, where you gotta walk around the city and then you go in the door and it changes the perspective from top down to like a platformer type thing.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You're tired, aren't you? And then Dino Wars, which you tested this one, didn't you? Dino Wars. This one was kind of hard, too. I don't think we got past, like, two or three levels, huh?
You don't have the
giant T-Rex. Giant T-Rex, yeah. I beat him. Did I beat him?
No, you don't get to beat him. You get to be him.
Oh, I turned into a giant T-Rex, that's right.
It's like a mech.
Yeah. But another little difficult game. There, you know, a lot of these little, the cheaper games can be really difficult. And I think if you actually played it enough and dedicated some time to it, you probably get pretty good at them. But for us, it's, you know, you start playing and you're like, oh, do I really want to devote the time to being good at this game? So, let's see here. And then today, or was it yesterday? I guess it was yesterday. you asleep? Hooper texted us and he said that he went back to the same place that we found the DS and that he's found a couple other things. It was sitting there the whole time. I don't know how we overlooked it, but he found this. I'll put a picture up right here. But he found this Sega Genesis arcade stick, 6-button arcade stick, and he got it for $10. And it's like, you know, pristine condition. So we walked right by that, huh?
Yeah.
Yep. So that's pretty much it for our pickups this week. Do you have anything you want to add? So, anyway, thanks for watching. I know we got a couple new subscribers, so welcome to the new subscribers. We're almost to 100. You know, we get like one or two every week, it seems. So we're getting there. At this rate, we'll, when you're 15, we'll be able to give away our 100 subscriber contest.
At least by the end of October.
The end of October?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So by the end of October, he's saying he thinks we're going to hit that 100 sub count, or that 100 sub count. So again, thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.